התחלתי להגיד, I started to say, בעזרת השם, that today is the yorset of Rabbi Yehuda Petayah, according to my calendar. בעזרת השם, Rabbi Yehuda Petayah, I want to say a few words. Who was Rabbi Yehuda Petayah? He was one of the big mekubalim that Am Yisrael had in the past few generations. He lived in Baghdad, in Iraq. He was Chevruta. There was three mekubalim in his generation.
How long ago?
About 150 years ago. One was the Ben Ish Chai. The one was the Ben Ish Chai. Okay. Yeah. And one was Rav... I just said his name. Rav Yosef not Lugasi. Agassi. Rav Yosef Agassi. Rav Yosef Agassi. And Rav Yehuda Petayah. There was like the three big mekubalim in that generation in Baghdad. And the Rav Salman Eliyahu, which is the grandfather of Rav Shmuel Eliyahu, he was their student. Wow. And he did, there was a few other rabbis, Rav Salman Eliyahu, Rav Dweik HaKohen, that came to Eretz Yisrael in the same generation, which is the last generation.
They come from Baghdad too, right?
Anyhow. Our subject matter for today is Rav Yehuda Petayah, because it is yourself. So Rav Yehuda Petayah Zatzal, he wrote a whole perush, a whole commentary on the Etz Chaim. And the Etz Chaim is a big book to write on. I think that the amount of words that there is in the Etz Chaim is approximately the half a shas kind of amount of words. Like it's a serious work. There's someone that I'm learning with him, basically, 3 times a week, Etz Chaim, every morning, 2 hours, for 3 years. Oh. We did a third of the book after 3 years. It's a big book. It's a very serious book, Etz Chaim. Anyhow, so Rav Yehuda Petayah wrote a perush on all of the Etz Chaim, Bet Lechem Yehuda. It's called the Bet Lechem Yehuda. There's many mekubalim today in yeshivot mekubalim that are learning his perush. He's one of the most accepted perushim on the Etz Chaim. And besides that, besides of the fact that he wrote such a big commentary on the Etz Chaim, the main thing that is known about Rav Yehuda Petayah is his book that is called Ruchot Meseprot. That really it's like a commentary on the Tanakh, but within the commentary of the Tanakh, there's a certain part about Yechezkel HaNavi, the Chazon HaAtzamot Yevashot of Yechezkel HaNavi. So there, the Rav Yehuda Petayah is very lengthy, is making a whole explanation about the whole thing of spirits that needs tikkun. Wow. And he's one of the mekubalim, one of the only mekubalim that we have that they wrote like a diary kind of their experiences that they went through when they were involved with giving tikkunim to spirits of people that were captured.
Dibukim?
They were dealing with dibukim. And the people today, for example, Rav David Batsri, that they are dealing with those things of the Bukim and so on, they are drawing their way of how to relate to that, mainly from the book of Rav Yehuda Petayah. The whole concept of Tikkun Iftarim, the whole concept that there is in Tikkun Iftarim. There's many yeshivot mekubalim, they do Tikkun Iftarim, the whole thing of Tikkun Iftarim, the source of that is Rav Yehuda Petayah. He's one of the top mekubalim that were involved with those things. So I just say one story. Actually, yesterday in my class, I was mentioning him, right?
Yeah,
I just spoke about that. I didn't know that the Yorzit is today. Anyhow, min hashamayim. So I'll say a different story. I thought to say the same story, but I'll say a different story. There's many stories there in there. So he's telling about a neshama of a person that he was very, very... a neshama of a person that was a big sinner. He was a big Rasha. He grew up like a very beautiful guy, very handsome guy, and he was living with all the ladies that he could get, and he was like mamash shatuf bezima, and he was mitgalgel afterwards. He was mitgalgel in all kinds of dogs and different things that were
part of
like
that. It was a gigolin of fruits.
It was no, that was a different thing, a different thing. Anyhow, so Rav Yehuda Petayah was really trying to help this neshama to get to its tikkun, and yet whatever, he had the ability to communicate with spirits. That was his quality. Is whatever, there's a whole thing there of the Bukim that this neshama of this wicked guy that came into a certain person that he had, and Rav Yehuda Petayah was able to remove the dibuk from the person, and then he started to speak with this spirit that he took out of the person and trying to bring it to its tikkun.
Wow.
Okay, and it goes through like a whole deal of details and the way of that he was treating this neshama, this poor neshama of this guy, and he was like doing all kinds of yichudim, meditations, and blowing shofar around to make a certain kavanah, certain meditation, a whole big deal. And then he found out that he's doing so much efforts to clean up the klipot that are grabbing this neshama, and then this neshama is going and it becomes to be like a dibuk and doing sins again. And it gets again all the clipot around it. So he said, Hashem, I don't know what to do with this guy. I was able to help many neshamot, but this neshama, every time I'm doing something to its tikkun, we're doing like one step forward, two step backwards. It's not going anywhere.
It doesn't go b'shniyah achad.
So he was dealing with it for quite a bit. So in the end, he had a chidush. He had a chidush, and he said that he found an introduction in the Kitve Arizal in Shara Gilgulim that explained that there is a possibility like that, when there is a situation like that the neshama doesn't get to its tikkun, to make a split in the neshama and to separate between the neshama to be two neshamot. That one neshama is the good part of the neshama that can get to its tikkun, and one part of the neshama is neshama that is like done. It goes to recycling. It doesn't go into another process of incarnation. And he had the strength. Rav Yehuda Petayah, he had the strength to pray to Hashem to do this process and to split the neshama into two neshamot and to get rid of the negative part and the positive part of the neshama to bring back in within incarnation. And not only that, Rabbi Yehuda Petayah continues and he...
Neshama
of the wicked guy, he split this neshama to between the good and the bad. The bad goes to waste and the good comes back within incarnation. And then, listen to that. And then, not only that, Hashem gave him, because he was such a big tzaddik, Hashem gave him the merit to see the baby that was born from this neshama. And they called Rav Yehuda Petayah to be the sandak for this baby. And he had the vision how the neshama comes into the baby, and then they called him to come to be sandak. So he saw that it's Hashgachat Hashem, that Hashem wants him to understand the message of what's going on here. And then he saw that this baby was very, very ugly baby. And he said, this is Chesed Hashem, that now this person that will grow, he won't be able to do those sins again, even though he will have the last, but he's so ugly that no one will go with him, and then he will be forced to get to his tikkun, and that's the Chesed Hashem.
Wow.
to make the situation for this neshama to go through a process of life without doing a znus, and then it will get to its tikkun.
אם אנחנו צריכים להגיע לתיקון של איך באיזה דרך לעבור לניסיונות.
Okay, so again, that's exactly the point, that in this neshama Rav Yehuda Petayah understood that it doesn't have the strength to stand in the niseyonot. So he was praying for this neshama to get to its tikkun. So Hashem took the prayers of Rav Yehuda Petayah so seriously that not only that he split the neshama, that's one level of Chesed Hashem, also the neshama, the part of the benefit of the good, of the good part of the neshama that came back, it came back in a way that it cannot fail the tikkun, basically, almost. To minimize the test. You're right. Look, as much as there is, the bigger the test is bigger, so then the gain is bigger. You're right.
But there's no test.
So when there is test, there's more reward. So this neshama will not have such a big reward, but at least it will get to its tikkun.
Yeah, but how? No, but there is. If you don't work, then you don't get paid.
No, listen. Okay, so what you're asking is a good question. Let me say the question in, and let's say that we're speaking about the same thing. You're asking, Hashem wants to give reward, and the whole reason that we are here is to go through a process that we have a nisayon, and we're standing in the nisayon, and then we're getting to the reward.
Yeah.
You're right. But reward is not yes or no; it is how much, right? Kol Yisrael yesh lehem chalek l'olam haba. What does it mean? Kol Yisrael yesh lehem chalek l'olam haba. That basically whoever is not doing sins is basically in a there is a certain minimal relationship between him and Hashem. So he's already like he doesn't have a big chelek, but he has a chelek. So there is that tzaddikim that they have nisyonot gdolim, and they go through the nisyonot gdolim, and then they have a big reward. So they don't have only cholek, they have higher levels.
But
you're right that it's better to go through nisyonot and to have the big cholek. It's better, but even when there is neshama that is getting to the cholek la'olam ba. So it's already got to the Olam Haba. So even if it doesn't have a big chelek in the Olam Haba, but it have a chelek. It's already within.
You're saying that mishu she bonagid she lo nasa velo ulo bonagid she ulo asa averot. Ken, aber lo 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 mitzvot. As ben adam kaze yikabel chelek Olam Haba. As I say that, kilo, im Kodesh Baruch Hu asa et hakol, shehu lo yipol, the en matzav shehu lo, echo yagi la tachnit shelo.
Say it in English. Say it in English.
No, I'm saying it very good in Hebrew.
Yeah, you're saying good in Hebrew, but I want the video to be so for English speakers.
So I'm saying that if someone is, he wants to get to his tikkun, right? He wants to get to his tikkun. Right? But if a Kodesh Baruch Hu gives him everything he needs, yeah, and everything he needs and no pitfalls, doesn't give him any michshalim, any pitfalls, yeah, any things to distract him, yeah, then it doesn't seem that he can get to his tikkun, right? Okay. So you explained that that really he can get to his basic tikkun. He can get to his basic tikkun, as in, even if you don't do anything, just don't do averot, yeah? Don't do averot, that will lose your Olam Haba, yeah? And you'll get the most basic tikkun.
Right. Yeah. Right. So Be'ezrat Hashem,
are you serious?
Now, I'll just to clarify, it's similar to what my wife's saying. There's a story about the Baal Shem Tov, I believe. There was one guy that was drinking all day, and just like he was going to the Bet Knesset just for Aleinu L'Shabeach. He was coming like in the end of the prayer, saying Aleinu L'Shabeach and go back to drink. That was the whole day for him. And people were saying like look on this, you know, poor guy. He doesn't have a life, doesn't have a wife, doesn't have anything in this world. Just coming and saying, that's all he does. What a poor guy. And one day the Baal Shem Tov, he heard it, and he told them, no, you don't understand.
Exactly.
This guy, he was a big tzaddik, big talmid chacham in his past life. And just, he was mezalzel in Alenu L'Shabeach. He was every time was going, he was leaving the Bet Knesset before the Tzibur was saying Aleinu L'Shabeach. Every time he was not saying Aleinu L'Shabeach. So Hashem brought him incarnated to the world just to say Aleinu L'Shabeach. That's all what is missing. All the rest he already did. He did the full tikkun.
That's
the story about Rabbi Hashem. I'm not saying that as a halacha.
I'm saying it's a bit muzar. It's a big tzaddik, and then pitom he doesn't believe in Aleinu L'Shabeach.
Whatever. That's not the point. The point is that we don't know. We don't know what is the cheshbon. We don't know what is the way that Hashem is planning the system
right.
of every neshama to get to its tikkun.
Right.
Okay. To us, many times things are seems very very difficult. Like why this thing happened to this guy? Why this guy is like that? Why all kinds of different things? Right. The Chafetz Chaim says if we would have lived like thousand years minimum, probably 6,000 years of the whole creation, then we could understand because we would have the full picture of what happened with this guy in this lifetime, in this lifetime. Then it makes sense why it's going in with him now. But for us, when we're looking at the last bit of where he's holding, so we don't understand why we don't understand because we don't have the full picture. Okay, anyhow, so let's go back to Rabbi Yehuda Petayah. That was the original, the old thing of the class today. Rabbi Yehuda Petayah, he was able to speak with those neshamot, communicate with them, ask them, like, what's your story? Where are you coming from? Why are you here? What do you need to get tikkun
from? Why don't you put filling?
And he was helping many, many people that had all kinds of different phenomena because of different dibukim and different things that came to them. And he was very successful in that. And all of that is brought down in his book, Ruchot Mesaprot, that how to bring those neshamot to their tikkun. And that's something that it's very important. Shalom Aleichem Ephraim, Baruch Haba. It's very important for us to understand, to hear those things, because it gives a lot of chizuk, a lot of strength of our emunah, that those things are real. It's not, when someone is doing something, positive, negative, whatever it is, it have a result.
Right.
And then afterwards, the person have to deal with it. And if he's not able to deal with it, so someone else will have to take responsibility over him.
So what's the
so that's so we have to make sure as much as we can. We don't want anyone else to do our tikkun, right?
So. Well,
that's goes back to the point. That goes back to
him.
Okay, so that's the point that you were speaking about the reward. So like Nathaniel said that. There is a chelak l'olam ba'an. There is the big tzaddikim, right? That they have like a whole bet midrash, right? The big tzaddikim, like for example, Rav Yehuda Petayah. So in heaven, he have a whole bet midrash.
Yeah.
Why? Because he took the responsibility on others' people's life.
Wow.
Someone that says, for me, I can't deal with my tikkun. I want to drop everything and that's it. And then someone else and goes and pick up the ball. Yeah? So he takes the person reward. So then the person is yev chelek la'olam haba, but he becomes to be like a sniff, like a branch.
Right.
A branch of the tree of the tzaddik.
He's not his own tree.
Right. So from here also we can understand what is the main quality of the tzaddikim, that they take the responsibility for Am Yisrael.
Right.
Wow.
This is the main point. It's not about knowing the whole Torah.
No.
It's not about like not doing sin, because we know that Sheva Yipol Tzaddik V'Kam and Tzaddik Yasher Yaseh Tov Lo Yachta. The tzaddikim they also have their things that they have to improve themselves. So what's the difference? That they take the responsibility for Am Yisrael, right? And that's what also Moshe Rabbeinu said. I'm carrying Am Yisrael like I'm carrying a baby, right? So this is something that we see that a lot in the whatever you read about tzaddikim. The read tzaddikim sometimes that you don't see that. For example, Rav Yehuda Petayah in his generation. He was not like the Ben Ish Chai. The Ben Ish Chai was the rabbi of the city. of Baghdad. The Rabbi Yehuda Petayah, he was very big tzaddik, but he was not like the rabbi of the city. So you didn't see the way that he's taking responsibility. Because what he did in his house, in his Beit Midrash, in a private way. But in the spiritual sense, it took a lot of responsibility.
Wow.
And that's also, by the way, it's a nice story that I always say about the Chazon Ish. That they came to the Chazon Ish and they asked him, why are you not going to do Kiruv? You're staying in your house all the time learning, but what about Am Yisrael? So the Chazon Ish said, no, you don't understand. When I'm learning in my house, the germs, the Chaydakim in my house, they're getting my Torah, and they go out, and they go into people, and then the person does tshuva. So I don't have to go out and to preach. I'm just learning in my house, but it goes by itself. So he said it about germs, but it's not about germs. There's a spiritual effect that we don't understand. So even the tzaddikim that we don't see them, right? The lama of dvav tzaddikim nistarim. We don't see them that they are taking responsibility for Am Yisrael. Why? Because they are hidden. That's the whole purpose, right? So how does it work? Spiritual sense, they take the responsibility. Like for example, Rabbi Yehuda Petayah, that they are dealing with the tikkunim of whatever is necessary. If it is the different neshamot, whatever it is. But they take the responsibility in a spiritual sense. And that's something that each person can take for himself. What is the level of responsibility that a person can take for Am Yisrael? As much as a person is taking more responsibility, Hashem is giving him the means how to do the mission that he takes on himself. Right? Because Hashem wants everybody to take responsibility and to do more for the tikkun of the world. That's the whole purpose. As much as you're making yourself to be a bigger player in the game of achieving this purpose of the tikkun of the world, so Hashem gives the person the means of dealing with whatever it is that he took for himself. And we see that by Rabbi Yehuda Petayah, that he was putting himself to do this mission, so Hashem gave him this ability, and he was able to really communicate with them and understand, and he was like, he knew how to do, he had the Seada Deshmaya, to tell the neshamot, like, you do like this, you do like that, you like all kinds of different, and he had the inspiration how to bring all of those neshamot to their tikkun, right? We don't have this inspiration. Why? Because we're not taking the responsibility. So Hashem doesn't give presents for nothing. Hashem gives a person a present if he has something to do with this present. If Hashem is giving someone a quality, if it is physical, if it is spiritual, right? Also, the same thing about physical. Someone that he have a lot of money. What's the purpose that he have the money? Must be that he have something to do with this, to help Am Yisrael. Otherwise, it doesn't go without a reason.
Actually, the word nisayon, it's la'alot otcha al nes.
Right. Right.
So, I think, what was I
going to say? So the same thing is about the, in the spiritual sense. When a person have a spiritual strength to do something,
I like when you speak English.
It's he have to use it to the right purpose. When someone is taking the present that Hashem gives him and he's using it for himself, to gain for himself, so then he lost the game.
Right.
Right. So I heard like many years ago about someone that, whatever, I don't want to get into the details of like who was it and what was his special quality, but he had some special quality that I understood that he was in a certain way taking advantage of this special strength that he had. And I had a feeling, and I also spoke about it with the rabbi, that I was in contact in that time. I'm talking about like 15 years ago. And that was basically the conclusion. And Lamai said, today you don't hear about this person anymore. What's the reason? Because when if you take something that it's not belong to you, it belongs to Hashem. Hashem gave it to you to use it for a certain purpose. So if you're misusing it, you're not taking the right advantage, you're not doing the tikkun that you can do with it. So it means that you're not in the position. You didn't really take the responsibility for Am Yisrael.
Daniel, יש עכשיו ערבית.
So
we'll,
okay. So we'll finish with that for now. That Bezrat Hashem, with the merit of Rav Yehuda Petayah and all of the tzaddikim and David HaMelech, will be salvations for whoever is here, whoever is not here, all of Am Israel, Amen. That everybody have their blessings that they need, Amen. Physical, emotional, spiritual, Amen. Whatever it is needed, Bezrat Hashem to Amen. Be in the good and sweet way, and Bezrat Hashem that will come to Elul with the right set of mind and use the time of the that we have until Rosh Hashanah and Kippur to really elevate and to get to those high days of Rosh Hashanah and Yom Kippur in the right spiritual position to do it right and to connect to Hashem as much as we can and to gain the potential that Hashem wants to give us. Bezrat Hashem.
Amen. Amen.